Hey everybody, Matthew Cook here, founder and CEO of GTC Golf Academy, and today I'm going to show you and help you execute a better shot on a par 3 that is 175 yards, with, as you can see, quite a lot of stuff going on in front of it. I have a huge bunker with a huge lip. If I was to stand in that bunker, I wouldn't see above it, so it's a pretty big lip. I've got also across this, like all the junk here, it's massively uphill to the flag, to the green. Now, from the tee box to the flag, I'm not necessarily level, but I'm not too far away. The flag and the green is a little lower than I am, so I'm hitting slightly down towards the hole. Now, I've got 175 yards. To the center of this green, and that flag is in the center, but it's in the right section. It's cut pretty tightly to the right side of the green, and the green, I'm not sure if you can see it so well, but the green goes angles to the right. So from this way, if this is the front of the green, this is the back of the green, it's quite big from front to back, but the width that I've got that I'm hitting into is maybe 30 feet. The width of it isn't huge. So 175 yards is what the numbers are, but slightly downhill. I feel like it's playing about 170. I'm gonna take 5 yards off of it because of that. The temperature's really nice. The ball's gonna fly quite well, and I'm feeling pretty good about my swing. I'm feeling like I'm swinging pretty good. I'm confident that I'm gonna strike it relatively solid. I think I'm either going to strike it pure, or I'm going to strike it still just solid. You know, some days you have them days where you're just like, I can't swing, I can't feel anything. I feel pretty good today. So I've got 8 iron. Now typically a standard 175 yard shot, I'd use a 7 iron maybe. It would be a force to hit an 8 iron, but I feel like right now, feeling good in this situation, 8 iron is probably a good number. Even if I don't quite strike it well, I feel like it's still enough to fly 165 to 168 yards, which is all I need for it to land on the green. So let's go ahead and play one. Now, it's really important that, typically I'd have the camera on a different angle, but I wanted you to see the hole. And typically what I see with amateur golfers is they struggle, especially with the low irons, to what I call cover the ball. So they get the chest to cover the ball this way. A lot of golfers, especially in a situation scenario like this, tend to hang back, try to lift the ball in the air. And you'll either fat it or you can thin it. Either way, like, the consistency in the strike is going to be really off because people hang back on this right side, try and hit the ball up like this. They don't get to the left side and get the chest to cover the ball well enough, which would get some shaft lean. You compress the ball better, a better strike, and ultimately you maximize that distance. So my focus in my practice swings here is going to be to get to my left side and cover the ball with my chest, just a couple of them before I fully get into my pre-shot routine, which I shift away from thinking mechanically or technically, and I get into the shot. Where I want my ball to start, where I want my ball to finish, how I want it to fly, the flight height, and then I see an image in my mind of what I look like if I was to be standing over there watching myself, what I would look like, and I try to picture good swings, good thoughts, good finish position, and all that just adds to my confidence for the shot. And we all know confidence is a huge thing. So let's get right into this pre-shot routine. Let's see if I can execute a pretty good shot for you here on camera. Right now, I'm just trying to be myself over there, watching myself make a nice swing and a nice finish. Now I'm just going to go back into my alignment and just double check. And now go into aiming the club face, which is the most important thing. After I've aimed the club face, which is a common issue for golfers, they tend to aim their body first. Aim the club face, get the body set up. And then once I'm set, I'm going to trigger. Oof. Caught the top of the lip. Felt pretty good. I hit the ball all right. Little thin. Well, not necessarily thin. I hit the bottom. I can see I hit the bottom three grooves. Just didn't take quite a strong divot. Didn't compress the ball enough, so I didn't quite maximize my distance. Caught the top of the lip. Now I have a treacherous bunker shot. But going through that overall process will help you hit better shots, especially with the short irons on a par 3. One as crazy looking as this. I'll see you in the next video.